Hey guys, Vikas over here and you are watching We Are Genius. Guys, today I am again with a new video around Raspberry Pi. We'll see how to set up Mycroft, or specifically the Pi targeted version of it, the Pycroft, to make a digital voice assistant. Well, you can pretty much buy a readily available assistant like Amazon Echo or Google Home. But installing Mycroft on Raspberry Pi will give us plenty of options to play with. And as we will have full access to the code base, it is customizable. Mycroft is an open source voice assistant primarily written in Python. To start with, as you are aware of, Raspberry Pi doesn't come with any audio input or onboard microphone per se. So to have audio input, I am going to use ReSpeaker 2 mic head from Seed Studio. These are pretty cheap and do the job. But if you are looking for a better experience, you can use something like the Mic Array 2. However, I have not used that personally. One more thing, with the speaker head, I was not able to connect speaker to head for audio output. I tried to use the JST connector as well as the headphone jack, but sadly that didn't work out for me. So instead, I went ahead with the default headphone jack available on the Pi itself. I have also used the LEDs available on top of the hat to work as visual feedback, which depicts the pattern of Google Home. If you want to know more about the hat, I'll put a link down below in the description to the earlier video that I made on it. So being said that, let's get started guys. So guys, to start with this, we'll download the Pycroft image from Mycroft website. And I'll provide the link to this particular page from where you can download the latest table disk image of Pycroft. So before downloading, just note that if you are going to use, you know, Raspberry Pi 2 and all, like below 3B, it is not supported, not that well supported. So you should be like using minimum a Raspberry Pi 3B model. So yeah, that's all about that. So I'll just go ahead and click on this link, which will lead me to this Google Drive page. Just click on download anyway. So this is around 2.6 gigs. So let's just wait till it gets downloaded. Okay, I'll just canceled mine because I have already downloaded. So it's my downloaded zip file. So I'll go ahead and use PyImager to burn or flash the downloaded image to the SD card. So over here I am using a 16 gig SD card. You can use anywhere between 16, like more than 16 basically. So I'll go ahead and use custom, then the path key, this one, I'll just select this one. Choose the SD card and click on write. So you can use any imager like Win32 disk imager or etcher. I'll just go with Raspberry Pi imager. So this is going to take a while. So we'll just wait till it gets flashed, and thereafter we'll be inserting that SD card to the Raspberry Pi with a speaker head connected, and we'll boot it up. Okay, now the SD card is flashed successfully. Hit on continue and we'll be removing the SD card from the PC. So over here we don't need to enable SSH, as by default Pycroft comes with SSH enabled. So let's just take it out and insert it to the Raspberry Pi and we'll put it up. So over here I have connected the speaker head to the Pi, and I have connected a display as well, and along with that I have connected a speaker to my 3.5 mm jack of the Raspberry Pi.
I tried this little speaker over here to connect to the head directly, but somehow that didn't work. So now just let's put the SD card to the Pi and we'll SSH to the Pi and we'll proceed with the further steps.
So guys, as Pi is connected to the network now, let's find out the IP address like taken by the Raspberry Pi. So over here, I am using advanced IP scanner. You can pretty much use any IP scanner or you can get the IP from your router. So in my case, it is 192.168.0.236. So I'll just go over here, connect to the Pi using SSH through PuTTY. So during the first boot, it will show you some configuration steps. So you can see over here, it is asking for would you like help setting up your system. So I'll go with guided setup. Yes. So it will check for updates, and in case updates are available, it will update it. So this may take a while, so let's just wait for it. So guys, the update is done. Now it is asking us for the output audio device. The PiCraft doesn't come with support for the Respeaker head by default out of the box. However, it supports the Respeaker mic array V2. So over here we'll go with Respeaker speakers via 3.5mm output. So I'll just click on one, and it is asking for volume 11 and all. I just 9. Yeah, I can hear it from the connected speaker. So I'll just paste D. Now it is asking for the microphone. So over here, again, I'll go with other USB microphone, as the Respeaker 2 mic head is not supported by default. So it is asking for an audio test. Now it will not work, but we'll just go ahead with this. We have not installed the drivers for the Respeaker head, so it pretty much won't work. However, let's just wait for it. Yep. So I'll click on select the third options. Now it is asking for you want auto update enable and all. Yeah. Then I'll stick with the normal Raspberry configuration. Then new password. I don't want to go with new password, so I'll stick with the default password. So yeah, everything is now set up. So any key to launch MyCraft, we can click and it will reboot. But if you in any time you want to come back to this particular wizard, you can use MyCraft setup wizard. So I'll just press a button. I'll get into the CLI of MyCraft. Yeah. So this is CLI. And you can see over here, the mic level is not there because the microphone is not yet connected. So I'll just exit from here. And I'll also exit from the virtual environment. So just hit on the activate, clear. Now we'll be installing the support or drivers for the Respeaker 2 head. So you can pretty much find out the details like drivers and all from this page from CStudio. So I'm just going to follow this up and it'll be pretty much good to go. So I'll just copy this command, I'll clone this repository. Then get into the repository. Then I need to do or run the install script. So this will add the support for the Respeaker 2 head to a Raspberry Pi. So this is again going to take some time, so we'll just wait for this till it gets completed. Just exit out of it. Yeah, as I was saying, the default password for PyCroft is Mycroft. So yeah, this one. Okay, anyway, let's just check if the drivers were installed correctly. So to do that, we can use AlsaMixer to check if the sound card is detected. So get into AlsaMixer, hit on F6, and you'll see something like SID 2 mic voice card. So I'll just press escape. Now we need to set the SID like microphone as input for our Mycroft or PyCroft. So as it uses pulse audio, so we need to type in the command. So I'll use pshtl list sources short. So this will list the input devices connected to the Pi, and this particular one is a SID Studio one. So you can check that out by removing short. So you'll see something like SID 2 mic voice card, and the ID is 2. So to make it as default device, we can use the command. One second, pshtl set default source 2. Now let's again get into the Mycroft CLI. And you can see now the mic level is come up. So over here you can see there are some comments that you can use while you are out of this CLI interface. And yeah, mic is working. Now we need to register our device to the Mycroft website, and to do that, just get into over here. One second, I'll just open up.
I'm connected to the internet and need to be activated. Open your browser and visit home.mycroft.ai to register this device.
So what we need to do is I'll just open up this one over here, account.mycroft.ai, and if you don't have an account, you need to register one. And if you have, you can. Yep. Now over here, get into devices. This one I actually already. Okay, and just I'm going to remove this one. I'll click on add device. We need to provide the pairing code, which can be found over here. So yeah, this one, VRU7EL. Then I'll just give it a name, Mycroft. And placement, let's put it lab. I'll go with American Mill. Wake up word will be hey Mycroft. So let's just click on next. Yeah, you can see it is connected. Now get into CLI.
Now I am landing in Minecraft to play the news.
And by the time you'll see voice prompts from your Minecraft. So you can ask simple like, you know, what is the IP address, or you can time for timing just to test out if it is working. Minecraft, what is the time? Okay, you can see over here, this is detecting like what is the time also, and it is also spitting out the result. It will be again audible through the speakers also. So we are all done with Minecraft installation. Now just to have the respeaker head comes with 3 LEDs on top of it. So you want to use that as, you know, as a visual feedback. To do so, I'm going to use the library for those LEDs and all, and I have written a simple script to interact with the Minecraft event bus. So I'll just open up that is message bus, so not event bus particularly, yeah, but if you want to check out the comments and all the events available, you can pretty much check this page. I'll just provide the link down below in the description, so you can pretty much go and check all the events available. And you can see over here, see it somewhere here over here. Yeah, message types. So you can get different events available from Minecraft. So what we can do is we can listen to these events, and if a particular event happens, let's say we are considering recognizer, right? If it detects wake word, it will we can listen to this particular event, recognizer loop, wake word, and we can do some sort of LED, we'll drive the LEDs and all. So for that, again I'm going to use the library provided by CStudio. So if you go over here, you can see something like, so we are going to use these LEDs and have some effects. So this particular GitHub repository does contain some of the effects Google Assistant or Alexa. So I'm going to use the Pixel one, and I have actually forked this library and appended some changes based on the Minecraft events. So I'll just go ahead to GitHub. So this particular repository hosts all the things that I will be using to interact with the LEDs. So what I'm going to do is I'll just clone this repository. So I'll just copy this URL over here, get into my Py, git clone this repository. But before that, we need to enable the SPI bus. Also, along with this, we need to install the Minecraft message bus client for Python. So to do that, we'll use the command Minecraft pip install Minecraft message bus client. So if you want to get into details of this, you can certainly get into this particular page. I'll just open it up. Yeah, over here, this has all the details, all the events and all, as I said earlier. Now we are all done, let's get into repository. We run as pixels.py. So over here you can see all the events that I am listening to. So wake word, record end, the audio output start, audio output end, sleep. Okay, let's try invoking Minecraft and see the LED effects if it is working. Hey Minecraft, what is the time?
2302.
Yep, you can see the LED effects are pretty much working. So now we need to run this file as a service. So to do that, I'll just exit out of it. So to write the service, I have provided the instructions in my GitHub repository, as well as this will be there in the website. So I'll just drop the link to that also. So this will enable to run the Python file by default when the Pi boots up. And if like somehow it crashes also, it will take care of that. So now reload. Then I need to enable it. And we can start this one also. Now let's just try once again. Hey Mycroft, what is the time?
It is 23:04.
Hey Mycroft, are you connected to internet?
I am on a wired connection.
And you see, this is pretty much working. Now just let's reboot. So the LED sequence is going to be, by default, it will be in think stage. Means unless until the Mycroft is ready completely, it will be in blinking state. Once it is ready, that will get into off state. Then when you ask something or it detects a wake up word, in this case it is Mycroft, it will start blinking. Then it will again start pulsing when it fetches the result from internet. After that, it will just fades whenever it is spitting out the result. And as you can see over here, as it is booting up, the LEDs are blinking one after another, as you can see. So when the Mycroft will be ready, it will go into off state. So the boot up may take a bit of time. So yeah, I need to wait. Yep, it is ready now. So let's just try out some comments. Hey Mycroft, say thank you.
Glad to be of service.
And you can see it is working and responding. So yeah, hope that it works for you also. And that's all guys, that's all with this. I hope you have enjoyed this video. If so, hit the thumbs up button. And if you have not subscribed to our channel, consider subscribing for videos like this. So see you next time with my next video. Till then, goodbye.